And the healthy aging in the digital world idea is to think about enabling technology that can improve the lives and well-being of older adults. I'm passionate about this big idea because I've been in the field of aging for over 30 years. And in my mind, the most important thing we can do is to add life to years. People are living longer, and solutions need to be developed to enable that time when people have much more time than they've ever had before to live to the fullest. And what that means is managing chronic conditions as well as possible, staying as functional and connected as possible, and having the best possible well-being with themselves and with their families.
My mom's extremely independent. She has always been very independent, and she was here in Davis independent. And then last year she got ill, and we've been just doing everything we can do to keep her here because she loves living in her own space. That is the most difficult thing because I don't think people know that it costs from $5,000 to $7,000 to have care in your home.
Bobby Bolden and Maybelle Carr are a duo that Bobby was my patient for quite some time, and then she moved her mother to the area and asked if I would provide care for her.
All right.
You look
beautiful.
Thank you. So do you.
The Betty Irene Moore School of Nursing was founded with the idea that we would improve health and we would improve health systems. And so throughout our work, it's always been focused on innovation, on leadership, on technology, on inclusiveness. I was always interested in how do you prevent people from ending up in critical care in the first place. And then once they are in a situation where they have some kind of a health condition or a crisis, how do you restore them to a life that they really want?
About a year ago, Maybelle had really taken a fairly sharp decline. However, I do believe staying in her home and being able to provide her with services and having her community around her has allowed for her to thrive and actually come back from where we didn't think things were going well.
But I've had to do a lot of caregiving. So I'm doing more caregiving than I ever expected.
The Family Caregiving Institute was funded by the Gordon and Betty Moore Foundation as an institute that would advance two main things. One is the education for family caregivers themselves, equipping them and helping them to enact their roles. The second is to help healthcare providers do a better job of working with family caregivers. We're sitting right now in the kitchen of our simulation suite that's a home environment. It has a kitchen, a bedroom, a living room, and a bathroom. And it's a place where we can actually educate our students, but also family caregivers, about how to deal with care in the home.
Maybelle moved into a community that's in our town that is a senior living community, so she has made friends and she's made relationships, and she meets with her group at the dog park with her dog, and that has really been something in her life that sparks her to be able to keep on going.
I love it, really. The people are so nice.
Telehealth is a critical part of this big idea. It's one of many of the enabling technologies that we're thinking about. And telehealth is really about connecting people over in a virtual way so that you can actually have conversations that are helpful. Technology has the potential to actually create greater access because you can be in a small rural community in Northern California and have access to state-of-the-art psychiatric treatment, for example.
My mom did everything for me. She allowed me to be myself, to do things I wanted to do. She encouraged me to follow my dream, to do anything I wanted to do. Even when I said, you know, I want to go away to college, we didn't have money, but she said, yeah, you can do that.
UCDAVIS is uniquely poised to do this. I've been thrilled from the beginning at the extent of collaboration and the diversity of opinion on this campus. UCDAVIS Health has been a leader in telemedicine and telehealth for decades now and is seen around the country as that leader. And with that, we've developed a great deal of understanding about technology and policy and working with partners all over the place to engage them in our vision. So that's a very strong basis for this work that we're doing now. And we have a number of different projects and research projects that are focusing on technology-enabled health, putting the person at the center and looking at how technology can improve health outcomes. So we're building on a very strong platform. And then when you add to that all the partners across our campus who are doing parts of this puzzle as well. and bring expertise in computer science and engineering and social sciences and humanities. All of those pieces all come together to weave to a really exciting future.
My kids thought my mom could do anything. And so for me to see her ill, and for them to see her ill, is really different.
Donor support enables us to bring people together to collaborate. It enables us to fund projects that they can work on together. And once good people with talent and lots of different perspectives come together and actually work on something together, then it begins to become exponential, because their ideas generate new ideas and new opportunities for funding. So that investment makes all the difference in the world.